Hi, my name is Steve Brostowitz, a teacher in transitional kindergarten, kindergarten and first grade, and today I'm going to show you some art projects you can do with kids between kindergarten through fourth grade. Now, I actually have experience teaching classrooms that have students with kindergarten through fifth grade in summer school sessions where students with special needs come to me to continue working on their academic goals. And each day I like to have some type of elective for fun for the kids and a chance for expression and a chance to do some other things besides your everyday math and reading. And oftentimes we'll do art. And I find that using finger paint and clay are two things all age students can do, and you can differentiate it for different age students, especially if you give them an open-ended assignment. Because if you give them something too structured and it's only a two-step activity, some of the younger students or students who are struggling more with their academics might find that just right, but the older students or the students who are more advanced will find that too easy. So give them something open-ended. You say, today we're going to work with finger paint, and you show them the finger paint, and you say, what I want you to do is tell me what you learned today, or what is the highlight of your summer so far. Give them something where they can take it in the direction they want. And the students who are more skilled might create a Picasso-like masterpiece, and the students who struggle with fine motor might struggle to get a couple lines down, but at least they can be independent if they have physical limitations and do the painting themselves and get just as much enjoyment out of it. You can also differentiate by the older kids just get the primary colors and they have to mix the ones, whereas the other kids might get all the colors, or they might be working on verbally asking for things if they're a student who is working on their verbal skills and their speaking is just emerging. Just asking a question such as, may I please have green, could be part of their goal. So you can see how you can take one assignment, let's paint the highlight of your summer, or let's paint what you learned today, and you can make it at different levels of difficulty. Same thing with clay. Now, if you look at the clay, with the clay, what are we going to do? Well, you don't need a lot of clay. A little clay goes a long way. And you can give them an open-ended thing where they can sculpt something as little as a ball, which will be difficult with kids, for kids with physical disabilities, and or make the old hot dog. Whereas some of the other kids who might be a fifth grader in your summer school class or in your classroom, and they have no issues with fine motor, and let's say that's an area of strength for them, artistic expression, and they're just there working on some of their math skills, they can take what I'm looking forward to most this summer, the Empire State Building. So you can see by giving that open-ended question and giving them a material that's highly engaging for kids of varying levels, accompanied with an open-ended question, you can get a range of results all the while keeping all the kids engaged. This has been Steve Brostowitz telling you some art projects you can do with kindergartners through fourth graders. I'll see you next time.